All right, today we're going to talk about the best cardio for fat loss. And the good news is that whether you are like a hardcore exerciser or you like to take it slow and easy, the two best ways to utilize cardio for fat loss fit in both of those categories. So the first one we're going to talk about is sprinting. Now, sprinting can be really intimidating because it's like super fast, super intense. So sprinting is great for people who love to just exercise so hard. You love to feel your muscles burn. You love to feel your heart pumping in your chest, all of that stuff. And the nice thing about sprinting is that it doesn't take a whole lot of time. You can get a really, really solid sprint workout in like 10 to 20 minutes, not including your warm up and your cool down, because it's super, super important that if you're gonna be sprinting, you have to warm up properly first. But a sprinting workout can look something like a 30 second hard sprint and a minute long recovery. You do that 10 times over and you're good. And it's like 5 minutes of super, super hard work, but it's really effective. So sprinting brings up this concept of exercise post-oxygen consumption, EPOC for short, which basically means that after you're done with a sprinting workout or a HIIT workout or any kind of intense interval training, your body's gonna be burning calories at an elevated rate long after the workout is over. Whereas if you just went on like a 3 mile run, pretty much when you're done running, your body just returns back to normal and it's not burning calories at that elevated state. So sprinting is a great, great, great tool for fat loss. And along with that, if you want strong abs, look at her, she's such a creep. If you want strong abs, sprinting is the way to go. Every time I do a sprint workout, I don't know why it still surprises me, but it does, that my abs are just so sore. So sprinting if you like the high intensity stuff. If you don't, if you like more low and slow, walking is gonna be your best friend. Now, walking to get like a similar effect to sprinting, it's gonna take a lot longer, right? But with the weather turning, the sun is out longer, the days are getting longer, which just feels so good. It's a great idea to get outside for a 45 minute, 60 minute walk most days of the week. Get those steps in, right? What walking does, you know, it does a lot of things, but I think one of the best things that it does for us is it helps manage stress. It helps us just clear our head, get outside, get into nature, and just calm down. You can put some music on, you can listen to a podcast, or you can just walk and be alone with your thoughts, which can feel kind of scary for people. But it is one of the best fat loss tools that you have that you're probably not utilizing. So I polled everybody last week to ask if they wanted this week's theme for lives to be more nutrition or fitness focused, and nutrition won by a landslide. But I did want to just pop this quick one in here just to say, you know, there are a lot of opinions about cardio. Should you be doing it? Should you not? It depends on your goals, which is true. It depends on your goals, on what kind of cardio, how much you should be doing, and all of that. But when it comes to cardio, the minimum effective dose is what you want to go for. So with sprinting, maybe 2 to 3 sprinting workouts a week, 1 to 2 if you're just starting. 2 to 3 if you're already at kind of like an elevated fitness level, just to kind of push those results along. And then the other days you're plugging in strength training, you're plugging in walking, you're sleeping, you're managing stress, your nutrition is on point. Then you'll reach your fat loss goals. And sprinting might help you get there faster. It's the same thing with walking. Just that daily movement, just utilizing that form of stress management can be so helpful to push your fat loss results along. So, 2 best cardio exercises for fat loss, sprinting and walking. All right, I hope this was helpful. I'll be back tomorrow. Have a good night.